Sister, I know you are there. Even if I can't see you, hear my plea. After your departure, it is now my turn to prove I'm deserving of our captain's trust. I will not fail, Chrysanta. And may the greatest of pains devour me if I let the penitents through this door. On your guard, penitent one! Forgive me. Now I will cross over to the other side of the dream and return to your side.
Thank you. will shatter the mirrors and trinkets in my tomb. Let its wail now grant light. Saita, awakener of the desolate, ignite these five lifeless eyes. These millennia of torment, my punishment, thread through my bones like poison. My forbidden passion is my penance. My golden virtuous strength armors me. I let this happen. I let this ardor grow inside me. But only the miracle giveth. Only the miracle taketh away. That governs my awakening has been struck. I must end thy irreverent intention, penitent one. And so, the long night is severed. Dawn cometh!
Penitent one in sleeplessness, carrying the guilty sword, you have committed the most serious crimes against the mother and her saints, against the miracle and its outbreaks. We have been entrusted with putting an end to your mission. I, Chrysanta in penance, excommunicate you, expel you, execrate you, with the blessing of our miracle of the greatest pain. And thus shall your name be erased under the heavens. Sword you wield. The high will sing that I must escape the kiss of its steel, as it is wholly tainted by the heresy of its bearer. The great ones, from the eternal processions, demand that I should battle until I draw my dying breath. The three. The high voices proclaim that your execution cannot be delayed. And so I fear that my penance is far from over. Not while their voices still echo. This pain that I feel It is deeper, more ancient. The guilt you carry has broken something inside of me. My faith, my soul is wounded. I will now walk to the chapel where it all began, where the first kneeling took place. Your first step towards atonement. Now leave me alone with my deep wound.
In my dreams, I heard your footsteps coming closer. In my dreams, I tried to talk to you and introduce myself. Guardian of the miracle and of the miracle banner, with great pain, I carry the emblem of the Father. I am the hands of bloodied skin. I am the eyes from which our mother gazes. But nothing I know of you, apart from your cold, nameless visage, apart from your calloused and wounded hands, apart from the mourning of your deaths. No, I know nothing of you. Only the miracle knows. Now may your sword, full of guilt, with mine of gold, collide. Let them hurt and march in procession. I curse you forever in name. I bless you forever in death. Now you see me awoken as the son of the true miracle. Thank you.
You have freed His Holiness from his afflicted torment. And now he walks by the old processions on the other side of the dream. The cradle of the grievous miracle. The final relic. The grail of blood and gold that emanated from the forehead of the Father as he silently lamented the moment of his blessed twisting. That first relic is here, at the top of the Ashen Mountain, next to the Turn Throne, where His Holiness was kissed by a miraculous pain. And now, your final communion with the miracle awaits. Only you will be able to know how much of it has seeped into your guilty heart.
My crimson figure and you on this side of the dream. The miracle has turned me into a sentinel of its sacred home. This is my new calling. What do you hope to find here that is not the blinding gray light that tempers our wounds and the vast horizons that extend without end? The path of paths has ended, and with it, so too has your penance. Now let your body, like mine, be bathed in blood. This will be your final resting place, but no one there is no point in recoiling from the desires of the all-knowing and all-powerful devil.
Behind my sword!
My final task is completed. I will go, and so too will all those who loved me. Now I will sink down here, in this land of clouds, in this realm of dust and glimmering lights.
The Guardian has fallen. The final truth awaits you. The final outrage. Go forward now, through the embroidered mantles, towards the light.
Penitent One. Who comes into our presence?
Bringing guilt to the most sacred of places, to the most forbidden of temples.
Breaking all laws, and thus desecrating His Holiness Himself. We are the High Wills. For there is no miracle that does not stem from our desire.
That is not our reflection.
That is not our word.
The word that was first made flesh and then sanctified.
Penitent One. Does not the pale, still light of this vast horizon hurt your eyes?
Of this procession, more ancient than us, that extends out before you without end nor beginning.
Of this brotherhood of grieving souls, held captive by their own condemnation and benediction,
this is the path of the ancient processions, the kingdom that the miracle wove from threads of dreams.
A domain where faith would unite in one single uninterrupted act of adoration.
That would give us light and time.
That would make us eternal.
And higher reaching than the sky itself.
You have come to this place to atone for your sins, to put an end to this work.
Destroying our flesh that once was word, and now is but silence.
Making us cast down our eyes, leaving the miracle bereft.
And so the last of our wills is your eternal condemnation.
In life and in death, in hunger and in thirst, in sleep and in wakefulness.
Buried under layers of ash, the ash of your flesh, bones, and sinew.
Execrated in visage, forgotten in name, forever and ever.
There is no penance that can exonerate this sin. It is the price to pay for the ultimate blasphemy.
Your final communion with the miracle awaits. Only you will be able to know how much of it has seeped into your guilty heart.
And thus shall your name be erased under the heavens.
And now, your final communion with the miracle awaits. Only you will be able to know how much of it has seeped into your guilty heart. Sins and sinners alike has had no mercy on you either. At the mercy of the miracle you were, and at the mercy of the miracle you remain. You are no longer anything but one more anonymous visage, without a voice, without countenance. Your penitence is over.